Warmastered edition. So, I'm doing something a little bit different for this video. In terms of recording, usually I record at night. I'm currently trying to record this during the day. So, if there's any additional background noises, like planes or neighbors slamming the fence gate that's like right next to my window, I apologize. I will try and edit around it if I can. But I am hoping to try and record more videos at the moment while I'm currently on holidays. And I'm also trying to increase the amount of videos I'm putting out every week, at least again while I'm on holidays. And if I can record stuff during the day, it makes it much easier for me to make more videos and get more videos going. Because often if I record at night, it means I can't edit it until the next day, and then I'll usually have to have it uploading the following night, which may or may not happen depending on how long it takes to render the video after editing. This way, if I can record during the day, I can at least try and have something, you know, either rendering or uploading or something happening, in theory, on the night that I record, and try and get as many videos as I can sort of lined up in my uploads on YouTube, and just sort of have them ready to go. That's the plan. We'll just see how well it goes with all the background noises, and I can literally hear a plane right now, so let's just see how this goes. I might not stick to this, I might end up just going back to recording at night, but it would be nice if I could do some of these during the day, especially since this Darksiders looks like it might get quite a lot of videos to try and get through this game, so I'd like to get as many as I can, get through as much of it as possible before my holidays is over. So, yeah, we'll just see how it goes. You know, as usual, any comments or feedback is appreciated. Whether or not how much you'll hear any of the background noises and stuff will, I guess, depend on A, how well I edit this video, and B, how good your like audio equipment on your end is. I admit when I'm editing, there's probably stuff that I miss purely because my headphones and stuff might not be good enough for me to really hear it, whereas somebody with much better quality headphones and stuff might be able to hear it. So, you know, again, feedback is appreciated. So, we'll be picking up back where we left off. In the previous video, I finished up saying that I was going to try and jump down onto a ledge and pick up some abyssal armor, which I have managed to do. I only had to reload once. I died the first time, but I did manage to get it the second time, so that was good. I was just worried because the very first time I did it, in my previous playthrough, this sneaky thing is trying to sneak up on me. They respawn once you hang on a sec, I need to check something. I think this might have. It's actually loaded the wrong It's like an air current lifts you back up. So I only had to do that twice. But the very first time I did it, I just could not get the timing right for when you sort of jump, double jump and then glide. I couldn't get the timing right and I would hit the scenery and then just fall into the lava. So thankfully that didn't take a really long time this time around. But I did spare you from having to see me go through all that. Was telling me that some of the tutorial prompts I noticed turn up in really strange places where it's like you've either already figured that out or it's not particularly useful. I'm just using the scythe a bit, just trying to level it up. Straightforward. Okay. You can see this little hanging blue thing. Things are good for an insta-kill. Fulcrum location has been added to the Chronicle. And let's... Oh, we can't really do anything right now. Swipe that gets me. Secret chests. With the fire hydrants. Anyway, this time it's I can use. good. So what have we got so far? Let me think, we've picked up two artifacts, I think that's right. We've got sacred chest. And there should be... Let's have a look at the map. And flows within walls, hands, and its destructive power increases. Very nice. That's what we're hoping for. Myself off an edge. another chest.
Destroyer walk unseen within the realm of shadow. By their blood we are bound. By their blood shall we be free.
I can no longer move within the shadow realm. Much of my power has left me.
You need not enter it. I will grant you the power to see into the accursed realm for a time. But to what end? What hope have we now against the Destroyer's foul sorcery?
Hope will not bring you freedom.
Yeah.
Actually, now is probably a better time to save. These are like little mini challenges. Just focus on the little ones. On these little guys. Because like with our previous fight, it should disappear once we meet our requirements. Thank you. shut up. Playing it on easy does make a difference, though. So I didn't have to embarrass myself too much there. But definitely gonna be saving after that. And one more challenge to go. Trying to think if I can remember what this one was. Kill 50 enemies before war's infected health depletes. Bonus souls will be rewarded for any remaining health. kind of saving up that health chest for the end. Number 50, and we have a nearly full health bar, so we should get a very nice bonus in souls. Block counter. War's reflexive instincts have awoken, allowing him to counterattack physical and projectile threats. Press right button just before the moment of impact, which is the same as the
sisters praise you.
He's just gonna go wander off. Ravager of the Sin Hands increases ward damage with environmental weapon attacks. inwards. The broken stair. Like, just a single stair. Or step. I don't know. I was trying to be a smart ass, but... didn't work out for me. Sorry, I thought there were stairs, but there are stairs over here. Because the game just auto-saves as you go. and you can't try and be sneaky and just reload a save once you die. You know, if you die, then you're dead and it's saved. And so, yeah, just being someone who's like compulsive with saving in games. Not necessarily because I'm afraid of losing all the time. Sometimes it's just, like I play Skyrim and I use a lot of mods. So I have to be careful sometimes when the mods break the game or stop things from working. Just having a lot of saves and backups and stuff is always helpful. And yeah, I guess I've just had some bad experiences with having to repeat huge amounts of progress again because other games crashed or like a mod's caused a problem and it's resulted in something unfixable, or I've like missed out on something because I didn't realize there was some games that, you know, like a point of no return where you know, once you go past a certain point, you can't go back to an area or you can't redo a thing, or whatever. And I've missed out on stuff, and I really hate that because I don't always have time to replay games and go through all of that. So I just, get a bit paranoid about my save files. And also because, as I mentioned before in other Whisper plays, I do love doing all the collectibles and stuff like that. So, because I'm really keen on collectibles, I hate missing out on them. And having save files is a good way to do that. Same with achievements. Sometimes, some games, you know, you only have the opportunity to get a certain achievement in a certain place, or if you make a certain option. So having a reload available so I can try and get all the achievements is also good. Wants to be friends. Oh look, it's giving us a gift. Which I will rudely send back to it. Oh look, it's got another present. Hey friend. Should have heard it, but it didn't. Oh look, we're playing a game. Just throw the cars back and forth. Okay, that was me doing a very poor attempt at dodging. Well, that wasn't challenging at all. there's an item up there, but we can't get it yet. So we'll just have to come back here another time. Doesn't hurt to save. Save all day, every day. Of course it bleeds. Why wouldn't it? Cutscene time. Somehow none of them saw him.
It's nothing.
They're not very observant, these angels.
He's right.
She's literally right on top of him. No wonder these angels lost the war.
Beneath the stench of this place, you can sense it, angel. Neither the White City nor the Black Depths. Something lost between. Thank you.
remember this being anywhere near as twitchy in here. Oh, it must be my settings. Maybe my controller sensitivity is like way too high. Sudden, everything's on fire. Let this be over. I'm just embarrassed. This is embarrassing to watch. Okay. kindly let me murder you. Doesn't hurt to recover a bit of health. Until then.